Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu. Wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lah, wa man yudlil fala hadiya lah. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ahdahu la sharika lah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. Amma ba'du, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, you are listening to us from actually this is my room after the AMS Dawra Association of Muslim Scientists, Muslim Societies of Nigeria, Muslim Student Society of Nigeria, the ABU branch, after I delivered the Dawra. Now we are presently on strike. The ASU is on strike, so we're at home. A lot of people suggested that the Dawra should continue, but I could not. I'm not actually in support of that to an extent because the present situation, some people might want to be at home, like me myself. I'm at home right now, but I try to make time to give a little bit of lessons and some books, two books inshallah, which maybe I'll be treating on a question in the AMS Dawra group, briefly, maybe 10-15 minutes videos inshallah with the baraka ta'ala. So the two books that I wanted us to treat is Khuz aqeedah tuka min al kitab wa sunnah as sahiha by Jamil Zain, and the second one is Hidayat al-Tullabi ila tariq al-Sahab, that of Uthman ibn al-Fudi. A guidance, Hidayat al-Tullab, guidance for the student of knowledge onto the path of righteousness. So inshallah today we'll start with the book Khuz aqeedah tuka min al kitab wa sunnah as sahiha. Take your aqeedah, take your belief, Islamic beliefs from the Qur'an and the sunnah, authentic sunnah, not just the sunnah. This book is written by Muhammad ibn Jamil al-Zain. He is late, may Allah have mercy on him. He is one of the contemporary scholars who died not recently ago, who taught from almost when you can say from cradle to grave. If one could say that, even at the point of his death, he was still trying to teach. Jamil Zain have written books like Firqat al-Najiyah wa Taifat al-Mansura, some one of his books that he has written. I'm trying to see if I can get it here. So, I've been back home, so it is a little bit not, or maybe in one of the books that's here. Okay, Jamil Zaino, I will not take much time to explain him, but he's an Ahli Sunnah, a Salafi scholar. He has written a lot of books and his aqeedah is authentic. So he said, Khud aqeedatuka min al-kitab wa sunnatu sahiha. Hold firm, take your aqeedah, get your beliefs, get your creed and belief from the Quran and the Sunnah that is authentic. Because not any hadith narrated from Prophet ﷺ is authentic. Not everything is qualified to be called a sunnah. Just like the hadith narrated by Imam Muslim, the Prophet ﷺ indicated that there are people who will come and bring in false hadith. Dajjaluna kadhabun. Al Imam Muslim, he narrated in his Sahih Muslim. So that means it's not anything that we will take. And Ibn Sirin is saying in his in the Muqaddimah of Sahih Muslim also, Baba anna al-isnad min al-dini. He said al-isnad la lam yakun yas'aluna 'an al-isnad fa lam waqa'at al-fitna qalu sammu lana rijalukum wa yanzur ila ahli sunnah fa yu'khadhu hadithuhum wa yanzur ila ahli al-bid'ah fala yu'khadhu hadithuhum. We've explained this in our dawra and this sort of problem. So let us hear what Malam said. He said inna alhamdulillah, all praise is indeed due to Allah. There's a difference between Hamida and Shukr. Hamida is thanking a person in all conditions that you find yourself. That is why the Prophet ﷺ, when something good is happened to him, he says Alhamdulillah. And it is something he doesn't like, he says Alhamdulillah ala kulli halin wa na'udhu billahi min hali ahli al-nar. So Allah says, Inna alhamdulillah, verily all praise is due to Allah. Nahmaduhu, we praise him. Wa nasta'inuhu, and we seek the help of Allah. وَنَسْتَغْفِرُهُ and we seek Allah's forgiveness. وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنْفُسِنَا. We seek وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنْفُسِنَا. We seek the help of Allah from the evil of our own self, وَسَيِّئَاتِ أَعْمَالِنَا, and our evil actions, because everyone has one or two sins that he is doing. كُلُّكُمْ خَطَّاءٌ وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ خَطَّاءُونَ التَّوَّابُونَ وَالتَّوَّابِينَ. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, all of you are sinners, but the best of sinners are those who repent. مَنْ يَحْبِهِ اللَّهُ فَلَا مُدِلَّ لَهُ. Him whom Allah has guided, there is no one that can misguide him. وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْ فَلَا هَادِيَ لَهُ. And him whom Allah has left to go astray, none can guide. وَأَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ. وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ. I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped. No one is worthy. None has the right and no one is supposed to be worshipped except Allah. وَحْدَهُ. He alone. لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ. Without associating any partners with him. وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. And I bear witness that Muhammad is a slave and his messenger. This is contrary to the aqeedah of the Shiites also, who all believe Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the Quran is not supposed to be sent to him but to Ali radiallahu anhu. And also some of the Sufis who believe that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not a man. And a'udhu billahi min dhalik. This is khutbat al-haja that is gotten from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad Nasir al-Din al-Albani, he wrote a book on this. Here's a copy of the book, خطبات الحاجة التي كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يعلمها أصحابه. He wrote a book specifically to explain this خطبات الحاجة. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم usually used to say this when he comes to give a speech or a sermon or a wedding gathering. Malan said, أما بعد, afterwards. أما بعد is what is authentic. وبعد is not authentic. Al-Imam al-Bukhari in his book Sahih al-Bukhari, he opened in his Kitab al-Jum'ah, he said باب أما بعد. أما بعد is what is gotten from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. هذه أسئلة هامة في العقيدة أجيب عليها مع ذكر الدليل من القرآن والحديث ليطمئن القارئ إلى صحة الجواب لأن العقيدة التوحيد أساس سعادة الإنسان في الدنيا والآخرة. والله أسأل أن ينفع بها المسلمين وجعلها خالصة لله تعالى. محمد بن جميل الزين. مالم سي فهذه أسئلة هامة. In this book, Malam this book in the form of questions and answers. So these are questions that of great benefits, that are of great essence. في العقيدة أجيب عليها. In terms, these questions are dealing with questions that has to do with one's belief, one's creed and belief. And I have answered the question. I will ask the question. He is trying to tell us the methodology in which he has written the book. He will ask the question and then he will answer it. مع ذكر الدليل من القرآن والحديث. Along with that, I will also bring the Qur'an, the reasons from the Qur'an and Hadith for everything that I have said. Just like we read in Aqeedah al-Raziyin, that one of the methodology of the pious predecessors is, one of the creed of the pious predecessors, the Salaf al-Salih, is that they go against writing books without you mentioning Qur'an and Hadith. So Malam from here, you know, Malam has what? And he's following the methodology of the Paris recessors in terms of his writing. لِيَطْمَئِنَّ الْقَارِئُ إِلَى صِحَّةِ الْجَوَابِ. So that the one who is reading this will be satisfied on the on the explanations that I will give him. لِأَنَّ الْعَقِيدَةَ التَّوْحِيدِ. Because the creed, the belief of Tawheed, أَسَاسُ السَّعَادَةِ الْإِنسَانِ فِي الدُّنْيَا الْآخِرَةِ. It is the way. This is the part of getting what? Salvation is a part of getting happiness in this dunya and what? In wal-akhirah, and in the akhirah. Wallahu as'alu an yanfa'a biha al-muslimin. I seek that Allah benefits the Muslims with this. Waj'alaha khalisatan lillahi ta'ala. And I pray that Allah makes this purely for his sake. Purely for his sake. Allah that is what? Exalted. And also seek and pray that Allah Azza wa Jal makes our works pure, and then he accepted for us Muhammad ibn Jamil al-Zayn. Muhammad ibn Jamil al-Zayn, he wrote this. So Madan opened a chapter. He said, Haqqullahi ala al-ibad, the right of Allah upon the slaves. So Mala, what is the right of Allah? Does Allah, yani Allah has a right upon his slaves? Nam, what are those rights? Bimada khalaqan Allahu? Mala ask a question. These are questions that need to be answered by every human. He said, Limada khalaqan Allahu? Why did Allah create us? Mala replied, Dawa, khalaqana li na'buduhu wa la nushrika bihi shay'a. والدليل قوله تعالى في سورة الذاريات وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. Malam said the answer to that question and the reason why Allah has created us. He said خلقنا الله أو خلقنا لنعبده. Allah created us to worship Him. ولا نشرك به شيئا, and we do not associate any partners with Him. Allah created us specifically to worship Him and not to associate any partner with Him. What dalil qawluhu ta'ala? Mala said, my reason for answering and saying this is the saying of Allah in Surah Al-Dhariyat. In Surah Al-Dhariyat, Mala said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. In Surah Al-Dhariyat, verse number 56, Allah said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ, I have not created the jinns. Wal insa, and the men illa liya'budun, except that the main reason is for them to worship me. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned the jinns first before the humans because of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which stated that the jinns were first created on earth, and when they were brought in on earth, they did a lot of atrocities, shed a lot of innocent blood on earth. That is why the malaika in Surah Al-Baqarah, when Allah Azza wa Jal said he's going to put إِنِّي جَعْلِ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَ, they said, قَالُوا أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَا. Are you going to put on earth that which is going to, مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا, who is going to commit atrocities, وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَا, and is also going to shed innocent blood? Because they said this looking at what happened earlier, what the creations that were placed there, which are the jinns earlier before man. That's what they are looking at. This verse, if we check the book Tafsir al-Quran al-Azim, Tafsir Ibn Kathir al-Dimashqi, in his volume number volume number 7, we'll see that in Surah Al-Dhariyat, where Allah Azza wa Jal is explaining, in just a minute, I forgot to indicate the place. Naam. Qala Ali ibn Abi Talha an ibn Abbas. Abdullah ibn Abbas interpreting this verse, wa ma khalaqtul jinna wal insa illa liya'budun. He said, "Illa liya'budun." The meaning of "illa liya'budun," except that they worship me alone, is "ay illa liyqarribu bi'ibadati du'an aw karhan," except that they should come closer to me, worshiping me. They should what? Get closer to Allah through worshiping Him, du'an aw karhan. Whether you in times where you like it and in times where you don't, whether you like the ibadah or you don't like it, it's compulsory to worship Allah. Therefore, one must worship Allah whether in times when he feels like and times when he doesn't feel like. Afwan, ay illa liqarru bi ibadati du'an aw karhan, except that what? They should affirm the worship of Allah whether in times when they like and times when they don't. Wa hadha ikhtiyar ibn Jarir al-Tabari, the first man to write a book of tafsir. This is also his explanation. وَقَالَ إِبْنِ جُرَيْجَ إِبْنِ جُرَيْسِ إِلَّا لِيَعْرِفُونَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ أي إِلَّا لِيَعْرِفُونَ, except that they should worship me alone. It means what? Except that they should what? لا ليعرفون, except that they should know me. Yani they should know who Allah is, bima'ana knowing the tawheed, al-asma wa sifat of Allah. And knowing the sifat of Allah alone without worshipping Him, that means you haven't worshipped Allah. And worshipping Allah without knowing Him, His name and His attribute, that means it's not Allah you worship, because you don't know Him. وَقَالَ رَبِيعُ بْنُ أَنَسِ Rabi' ibn Anas said, إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ regarding the sin of Allah, إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ except that they worship Him alone, أي إِلَّا لِلْعِبَادَةِ except that they should worship Him, al-ibadah. وَقَالَ السُّدِّي say, مِنَ الْعِبَادَةِ مَا يَنْفَعُ وَمِنْهَا مَا لَا يَنْفَعُ part of the worship is that which is what? Which is beneficial worship, and there is worship which is not beneficial. Mala wants to explain further here, because the rules of the Quran is for you to interpret the Quran, you have to take the verses before and the verses that come earlier. I say, وَلَئِن سَأَلْتُن مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَيَقُولُنَ اللَّهِ and if you ask the kuffar who created the heavens and the earth, لَيَقُولُنَ اللَّهِ they will say that it is Allah. Now you see, هَذَا مِنْهُمْ عِبَادَةِ وَلَيْسَ يَنْفَعُهُمْ عَنْ مَعَ الشِّرْكِ he said, this is an act of worship, tawheed al-rububiyyah, accepting that Allah is one who created the heavens and the earth. Allah is one who created everything. But despite this act of worship, tawheed al-rububiyyah, it is not still beneficial to them, because they still associate partners with Allah. Therefore, even if you worship Allah or you associate partners with Him, you should know that that ibadah is nullified and your tawheed, yani Islam, is nullified. With time constraint, I'll have to stop here. And inshallah, next we will explain the verses that came in and the explanation of this. So with this, I say, Subhanakallahumma bihamdika ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. You can forward your question, inshallah, in the next video. Subsequently, I'll answer them. Jazakumullah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.